Greetings. Psalm 23:1. A Psalm of David. Yahweh, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Yahweh God is the shepherd of Prophet David. Psalm 78:52. But he led forth his own people like sheep, and guided them in the wilderness like a flock. Yahweh God is the shepherd of the nation of Israel. Psalm 80, verse 1. For the choir director, set to El Shoshannim, Eduth, a Psalm of Asaph. O give ear, shepherd of Israel, you who lead Joseph like a flock, you who are enthroned above the cherubim, shine forth. The shepherd of Israel is enthroned above the cherubim. Isaiah 40, verse 10. Behold, the Lord God will come with might, with his arm ruling for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his recompense before him. Like a shepherd he will tend his flock. In his arm he will gather the lambs and carry them in his bosom. He will gently lead the nursing ewes. The prophets of God describe Yahweh as a shepherd. Isaiah 53:6. All of us, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way, but Yahweh, the Lord, has caused the iniquity of us all to fall on him. We are compared to sheep in our dependency on him. And in the New Testament, this imagery, this metaphor, continues. As a Jew, Jesus knew the Psalms and the prophets, that they called Yahweh God the shepherd of Israel. And even knowing that, Jesus said the following about himself. John 10:11, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. Jesus has just called himself the good shepherd. That is another tacit claim to his identity as Yahweh God. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. Jesus has just laid out the steps of a logical proof. Given fact 1 and fact 2, the logical conclusion is that Jesus will die for his sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd, and the sheep are not his own. When he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf pounces on them and scatters the flock. A hireling simply does not have the vested interest in sacrificing himself for the sheep. The man runs away because he is a hired servant and is unconcerned for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep, and my sheep know me. Again, Jesus calls himself the good shepherd. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. Jesus repeats and personalizes his claim that the good shepherd will lay down his life. Jesus says, and I lay down my life for the sheep. And I lay down my life for the sheep. Make no mistake, Jesus revealed and taught that he would die. Satan's claim that Jesus did not die is just that, a lie from Satan's lips to Muhammad's ears. I have other sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them in as well, and they will listen to my voice. Then there will be one flock and one shepherd. One shepherd over one flock. The reason the Father loves me is that I lay down my life in order to take it up again. Notice a third time, Jesus says he lays down his life. But this verse always gives me pause for the other thing Jesus says. The reason the Father loves me is that I lay down my life. There is an implication to this that is very revealing. Jesus asserts there is a reason that God the Father loves Jesus. And the word for love in this context is agape. We'll get to ask Yahweh about this in eternity. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down and authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father. Muslims attacking the gospel mischaracterize the crucifixion of Jesus as murder. But Jesus himself refutes that misrepresentation by saying, "No man takes his life. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord." So three times Jesus calls himself the Good Shepherd. Three times Jesus says he will lay down his life for the sheep. When God repeats his message three times, we had better pay attention and respect what he is saying. And in the New Testament, this imagery, this metaphor of sheep and shepherd continues. Matthew 26:31. Then Jesus said to them, "This very night you will all fall away on account of me, for it is written," that's an expression that references scripture, "for it is written, I will strike the shepherd and the sheep of the flock will be scattered." Mark 14:27. Then Jesus said to them, "You will all fall away, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd and the sheep will be scattered." Zechariah 13:7. "Awake, O sword, against my shepherd and against the man, my associate, declares the Lord of hosts." Notice this is God talking. The Lord of hosts. "Strike the shepherd, that the sheep may be scattered." Yet another further other prophecy fulfilled and identified by Jesus himself as fulfilled. Hebrews 13:20. "Now may the God of peace, who through the blood of the eternal covenant brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep." They refer to Jesus as the great shepherd. 1 Peter 2:25. "For you were like sheep going astray, but now you have returned to the shepherd and overseer of your souls." Isaiah 53:6. "All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all." See how the apostles tied in the scriptures, the prophets, into the gospel of Jesus. Psalm 119:176. "I have gone astray like a lost sheep. Seek your servant, for I do not forget your commandments." Prophet David even used the imagery of being a lost sheep. 1 Peter 5:4. "And when the chief shepherd appears, you will receive the crown of glory that will never fade away." Jesus is the chief shepherd, and we look forward to his returning. Jesus is the Good Shepherd, and we know the Good Shepherd is Yahweh God. Jesus is the Good Shepherd, and he loves you enough to give up his life to pay for your sins. His gift is free for you to receive, but you must accept it. Recognize, realize that Jesus has come to the earth in the flesh. Believe Jesus is Lord, meaning Jesus is Yahweh, God, and you will be saved. Romans 10:8. But what does it say? "The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart." That is the word of faith we are proclaiming. that if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with your heart you believe and are justified, and with your mouth you confess and are saved. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.